Couple examples from 4.5a and from b as well. If you're struggling with some of these, simplifying the radicals. To start, we'll start with number 11. It is square root of 45 over 3. Again, we can split the radical both as products or as quotients. So this will be equal to square root of 45 over square root of 3. So, you know, we got to simplify the 45, and there's like 9's a perfect square we can use, but you can't have the radical in the denominator, so I'll have to rationalize that out of there. So I'll just kind of simplify it a little further first. Like this can become square root of 9, square root of 5, over square root of 3. And then I'm going to start working vertically now. We can make this 3, square root of 5, and square root of 3. So we've done all we can in the numerator. Now down here, we've got to rationalize this to get rid of it. Again, you're multiplying by 1. Well, not just plain old 1, but square root of 3 over square root of 3. Whatever you have here, whether it be a binomial, I'll show you a few of those shortly, or this monomial, multiplying by 1, a fraction of whatever the denominator is over itself, to clear that out, you're creating a perfect square. Because 3 times 3 is 9, and square root of 9 is 3. So you're cleaning this up pretty quickly. And then the mess is moved upstairs normally, but that's just the way it is. So we're going to, we multiply these also. They're both inside the radical. So it's 3 times square root of 15 and square root of 9, which we know to be 3. So it's going to be 3 square root of 15 and for the simplification, those are gone. The answer is just square root of 15. That's number 11. Let's also try, I have number 15 selected for you. Now we're rationalizing, again, this is 4.5a, rationalizing the denominator, but it's got a binomial here. So for this one, we are, I'll rewrite it for you first, 1 plus square root of 5, 5 plus square root of 5. By the way, please don't try to do these on this paper. There's not near enough room. You're going to need some extra paper to do these. All right, so to rationalize, again, we're multiplying this, the original problem, by the denominator over itself is just 1, so it's 5. Now, well, in this case, we change the sign. Because we're trying to create one of those shortcut factors, 5 minus square root of 5. And I showed you the example earlier. By having these different signs, the middle term will cancel out. You have a negative 5 square root of 5 and a positive 5 square root of 5. They cancel out. So all you have to do is square the first number, is 5 times 5, which is, I'll put it over here, which is 25 minus the square root of 5 times 5 is 25 as well. And you created the perfect square here. So this will clean up on the denominator. And upstairs, you got to multiply. Now, you're going to be doing FOIL here. Now look, this does not, you have a negative square root of 5 with the outsides. The insides gives you a 5 square root of 5. So you're not going to get rid of the radical. It's still going to be up here in the numerator. So using FOIL, 1 times 5 is 5. 1 times negative square root of 5 is negative square root of 5. Now the insides, square root of 5 times 5 is going to be, it's positive, so it's plus 5 square root of 5. 5 times square root of 5. And then negative square root of 25. Negative square root of 25. So when you rationalize, even though this is 1, it cleaned up down here for you nicely, this will be gone. You're still going to have the square root of 5 here. So stepping forward through this, I'm going to simplify this and combine terms here. So I'm going to have 5 minus, let's see, actually plus 4 square root of 5 minus 5, because the square root of 25 is 5. Denominator is 25 minus 5. All right, this negative 5 and this positive 5, they go away, and 25 minus 5. So the top just has 4 square roots of 5. Down bottom, 25 minus 5 is 20. Well, these two terms can simplify further. The 4 and the 20, I can divide both these by 4. My answer will then be square root of 5 over 5, and there's your answer for number 15. All right, I'll show you a couple on the B side as well to help you. B side. I have chosen number 5 and 9 on this side, in case you're struggling with these types as well. So here's 5, I'm just gonna rewrite it for you. Square root of 8 times 3, square root of 40 times square root of 3. Now there's all kinds of ways to solve this. I could combine all of these radical signs into a very large number in there, but I want to try to find perfect squares. I want to try to create the perfect squares. None of these right now are, but I know that factors of 40 are 8 and 5, and they'll be inside the radical, and that 8 and that 8 will give me a 64. That's a big chunk right there I can get rid of. So I'm going to rewrite this, small change, square root of 8 times the 3, and I'm going to turn that into square root of 8, square root of 5, because 8 times 5 is 40. 40 was in the radical, 8 and 5 under the radical, times square root of 3. Now these two will join nicely to give me, I'll put the 3 out front, square root of 64. These aren't going to go anywhere, square root of 15. And then 64, of course, would be 3 times 8, and be 24 square roots of 15. And you're not going to do much for that. All right, last one for you is number 9. A little different with the fraction and the radical. So it's going to be 9 square root of 24 times, again, I'm showing you everything here so you see every step. Okay, I'm just going to split the radical so that we can then work independently on the numerators and denominators. So this is going to be equal to square root of 24. Leave that alone for now. I'm not sure where that's going. Times square root of 80 over the square root of 192. Okay. All right. So right now I'm not seeing much. So I'm just going to try some things here. This is a 4 and a 6. No, 6 and 5. All right, I'm going to try to break things down to the largest perfect squares I can find. 24 is going to be square root of 4 times square root of 6. Again, there's other ways to do this. This is just one of many. There's the big dot. This is square root of 16 times the square root of 5. And this, I think, is 64 times 3. So square root of 64 times square root of 3. All right, well, I got some perfect squares to clean up. Let's do that first. So this is 2 square root of 6 times 4 square root of 5. And this is then 8 square roots of 3. Now, you know, don't be confused by this fraction here. This is just over 1, so I can multiply things straight across the top, straight across the bottom, which I'll do right now to clean things up a bit. 2 times 4 is 8. 6 times 5 is 30. The bottom's 8 times square root of 3. Well, here's a quickie to clean up right away. The 8s are gone. And we have square root of 30 over 3. Now this is something new we haven't seen yet. We'll be seeing more of these later. Again, since they're both in the radical, well, let me just do an example. I'm just going to sidetrack over here for a second. When we multiply, you know, you have 2 square roots of 3 and 4 times square root of 3. When you multiplied, you could multiply what's inside together, right? So you have 2 times 4 is 8 and 3 times 3 is 9. And then that would become a 3, right? Well, you can divide as well. I can just divide these straight up, and 30 divided by 3 is 10. So this is going to become square root of 10, of course, over 1. That's the answer. Now, if you're not seeing that, no sweat. You can still rationalize the denominator, and we'll still get to the same answer. Let me show you. So again, for rationalizing, I take the square root of 3, as multiply that over itself, times 1. So I now have square root of 90. Over the square root of 9. Well, this will become square root of 9 times the square root of 10, and this becomes, well, it's just still square root of 9. They cancel out, and you still have square root of 10. So you get there either way. So we'll practice more of these later. We go directly from this to that. All right, good luck.